Good evening. I'm Minette Streeter, and this is Music and Taxes. Good to be back with you. I know I had to take about a three-month little vacation for medical reasons, and I am back in full swing, starting the new year of 2008. I want to start this year with something completely different, not just taxes, but a little international friendship. Many people in the Pensacola area, when they have found out I have been with the Russian Ballet over the couple of months, have said, Minette, we didn't know that they're in the area. How do we get to see them? How do we get to see their productions? So I'm going to start out the year just fine with this, partially because I was with the Russian Ballet New Year's Eve, and we had a fantastic time, and the people in and around us just welcome the Russian Ballet with open arms and open hearts. So if you'll want to go to your internet website, go to willisballet.com, and you're going to see this wonderful homepage. Check on all of it. This has been brought by Dr. Peggy Willis Arneo. She is a retired professor of Russian classical ballet, and she has moved into our area. So she has been bringing the Russian Ballet to the United States for over 30 years. This particular ballet company is going to be doing a wonderful presentation of the last seven words of Christ, which is a religious theme, the story of Calvary, danced by the Russian company from St. Petersburg, and they are the gold medal winners from Russia. They will be presenting this in Panama City, February 14th and 15th. So there's still time for those of you who are seriously interested to be able to get tickets and get down there to see them, because they will be going back to St. Petersburg, Russia shortly thereafter. They come once a year, and they do an American tour. So they're in and out. They usually only do two productions in Panama City. One is the Nutcracker during the Christmas time, and now this brand new production. But they have what their R&R time at their North American home theater down in Panama City, and that's when I take a run down there to see them. We're old friends. They have been guests in my home here in Pensacola. So that's one friendship announcement that I want to make. Before I show you the screen, I want to tell you a tiny little story about why this is not only important to Pensacola, but it's personally important to me. During President Reagan's term of office, as many people in Pensacola know, I designed a lot of the peaceful, non-political television. I had a wonderful call from the White House, and I accepted the challenge. During that period of time, I developed a show called Capital to Capital that was seen worldwide. The host on the American side with Congress was the late and great and sorely missed Peter Jennings. May he rest in peace. On the Russian side, now it was still USSR then, but I say Russian. On the Russian side, with the Politburo, was the award-winning journalist Vladimir Posner. That was seen. And after the series was over, I asked the embassy if they would send Vladimir down to Pensacola, and he came. He was part of a journalism conference that had been put together and hosted in part by the Pensacola News Journal. And it was held at the University of West Florida under the auspices of the Communications Department. I was with Vladimir at a meet and greet on the Friday night. There was a major panel discussion at the university on Saturday. We had the luncheon on Saturday afternoon, and then he was guest speaker that evening at the university. That was a number of years ago. Times have moved on, and about a year and a half ago, I may be mistaken about the time frame, so please don't hold me to that. Forgiveness policy in effect. A magazine came out. I had been in contact with the Moscow Times off and on for a couple of years. And a new magazine came out called Russia Today. Vladimir Posner was on the board of directors, and it was wonderful. He also happens to be president of the Academy of Russian Television. This year, just before the holidays, this wonderful television came out. You can get it, russiantoday.ru for Russia. This has got news, business, entertainment, science fiction features. I have clicked on the entertainment, and I'm going to scroll down to this wonderful live. This one is not live. Many of these segments are live, though. This is a film segment about a band. Let's click on the video right here. And bingo, we are going to get an anchor person.
Now, 4 million and counting, that's the number of times an amateur music video put on the internet by a known Russian band has been downloaded, putting Peter Navich and his friends on a fast track to fame. Ryan Dorrit has more.
Peter, come to my borderline.
If you want to see the rest, you know how to get it, russiatoday.ru. Click on the entertainment and scroll down and you'll be able to find Peter. I have to kind of laugh. And yes, sometimes I'm a little jaded, sometimes a little cynical. But when they say that it's a little rough around the edges, I think a lot of people are very glad, because people are being themselves on YouTube and MySpace, and they don't look like they're out of a tin can. So enjoy the peace and the friendship between countries via the internet. We'll get back into the tax issues next month. Have your pencil and paper ready, because we're going to get into some hard tax issues. Thanks for watching. I'm Minette Streeter. Good night.